Hi guys, this is me Gayatri Agal and welcome to my page. Ellarkum ende page lote swagatham. Here I would like to discuss with you all about 11th of March 2023 OET exam, in which I am detailedly explaining about OET writing. So what was the letter? It was a known case letter, a district nurse writing a letter to a patient's own GP. So let's move on to the case note. Patient name was Kathleen Salmi, who is 71 years old. Patient was admitted in the hospital on 27th of December 2022 due to osteoarthritis management. As the management of osteoarthritis, the patient has undergone hip replacement surgery. So after the surgery, patient started with a physiotherapy session and patient walked well and patient showed a good progress in the health condition. Thereby patient got discharged. So since the date of discharge, the patient has been under home visit of district nurse. When the district nurse started to do the home visit, each home visit patient has complaints about decreased mobility, low mood, and also patient not walking and not cooperating with the treatment and also not compliance with the medications. So thereby what happened to the patient? The patient end up with wound infection and the patient suffered with depression. So for the each shift, each visit, the district nurse was referring the patient to a patient's own GP. So the very first time, patient was not cooperating with the physiotherapy session and also decreased mobility. Thereby, the district nurse referred the patient to a GP. The GP seen the patient and advised the patient to continue the physiotherapy sessions along with the exercise programs. And during the second visit, patient was in low mood and also patient was not compliant with the medications. And the district nurse noticed that patient to have an infected wound. So thereby, the district nurse again referred the patient to a GP. The GP advised the patient to continue the medications as per the doctor's advice. And second thing is, GP prescribed the patient with antidepressant medications and also continued aseptic dressings. And today is the last visit. The last visit patient, the district nurse seen the patient and she came to know that there was no improvement at all in the patient condition. So thereby, here, the district nurse again writing a letter to a patient's own GP to increase the antidepressant dosage as well as to advise the patient to compliance with the physiotherapy programs to enhance the mobility of the patient further. So this was the letter which they have asked on 11th of March 2023. So here, how we are going to write a letter? Because it's a known case letter. As we know that for the known case letter, it is better to avoid the social background, because social background is not necessary, because we are writing a letter to a patient's own GP. He knows that already what are all things he is having, what are all medication he is having in the past. So currently, which means today, what happened to the patient? Why the district nurse is referring a patient to a GP? Okay, so now as usual the date. So the date they have given on the day of examination was 8th of January 2023. So that's the date we are writing on the top of the letter. Now we are writing the address. Address is the who is the reader. So the reader is the patient's GP. So we are writing the patient GP's address and then we are going for the salutation, dear doctor, or if the name is given, you have to write the dear doctor surname, and then we are just going into the patient reference. So reference, we are writing the patient name, Mrs. Kathleen Salmi, and then age is 71 years old. Now the main thing is we are coming to the introduction. So introduction is the main part of the letter. So here to make an introduction, we need three things. One is patient full name, the second thing is patient diagnosis, and the third thing is patient, like the purpose, why we are writing the letter to this reader. Okay, so patient name is Kathleen Salmi, and patient diagnosis, total hip replacement surgery, but it has happened on 27th of December 2022. So at the moment, the problem is patient suffering with a low mood. So that is the priority that we have to write it in the introduction rather than writing who has undergone hip replacement surgery. So it is better not to write that one. So how we can make an introduction? So Miss Kathleen Salmi, who has low mood and recovering from replacement surgery, full stop, she requires your further management and treatment, or else she requires your medication review, because patient has low mood and mainly the nurse is writing to improve, to increase the dosage of the antidepressant. So you can write like this also. So she requests your medication review and further management, like that also we can write it. This is one way of writing an introduction. So what is another way of writing an introduction? As we are writing this letter to a patient's own GP, right? So we can write, I'm writing to update the current health condition of Mrs. Kathleen or Miss Kathleen Salmi, who has low mood and recovering from hip replacement surgery. She requires your medication review and further management. So like that also we can write. So choices yours. So two way also we can write. The main thing is we must inform the low mood in the introduction itself. Now coming to the present medical history paragraph. So here, the present medical history paragraph, doctor knows all the visit, what was happened to the patient and what was happened in the hospital as well, because the district nurse was recurrently referring the patient to the GP, isn't it? So here, before you are starting the present medical history paragraph, it is a good idea to start with, as you are aware. As you are aware, comma, Mrs. Kathleen has been under my home visit since the day of discharge. During my visits, the patient was noticed to have low mood, poor mobility, and lack of compliance, or else non-compliance with the medication regimen, full stop. Therefore, the patient advised by you to compliance with the medications, physiotherapy sessions, and also initiated with otherwise, and was commenced on antidepressant medications. However, patient still suffers with the same condition, and also today patient was noticed to have low mood, and then not compliance with the medications and the infected wound. So here we are completely avoiding the social background because the doctor already knows about your patient condition. It is not mandatory, but we can give a hint what was happened during the previous visits. That is very much important to write it. Otherwise we don't have anything to write it in the letter. And then we have to go to the today's visit very separately. We have to write today she was revisited by a district nurse. So then we have to start during my today's visit. She was noticed to have low mood, poor compliance with the medications, and also refused to attend the physiotherapy session. So that is the thing we have to mainly elaborate it as in a separate paragraph. Now, coming to the recommendation paragraph. The fourth paragraph is called it as a recommendation paragraph. There we have to start, in view of the above, comma, kindly assess the patient's medications, especially antidepressant medication dosage, and advise the patient to compliance with the physiotherapy sessions. So like that, we are just giving a recommendation to the doctor that what he has to do for our patient. So that is the thing we are writing in the recommendation paragraph. Then as usual, coming to the conclusion, like, please contact me for further details, and yours sincerely or faithfully. If the addressing person name has given in the letter, you must always complete the letter with yours sincerely. And if they have given only the designation of the addressing person, just complete the letter with yours faithfully. So that is more than enough. So this is the way you have to complete the letter. And another thing is, like, when you are writing the patient's dear sir or madam, there it is not mandatory to put comma. And also when you are completing the letter with yours sincerely and faithfully, it is also not mandatory to put the comma, because it's not mandatory. It was there, but nowadays they are saying as per the OET, it's not necessary to put the comma. So we can just simply write it and bind up the letter. So this is the way we have to write this letter. It's a one type of method of writing this letter. And I hope everyone have done in a very good way. And also 25th of March, we have an upcoming exams, and prepare it in a very well. And we have a mock batch classes, and we are writing, listen. We have writing, listening, reading, speaking. And also we have 10 days, 20 days classes, and 40 days classes, and also beginners classes also running. Whomever wants to join in our class, our number has given in our description. You can contact us at any time. So until then, bye bye.